SPIDER's a millimeter wave polarimeter, and it's designed to image the polarization that's in the microwave background radiation. The ultimate goal of SPIDER is to see to what extent we can identify a very characteristic feature in that polarization that's expected to have come from the earliest stages of the evolutionary growth of our universe.
SPIDER will basically map out a portion of the sky, and we're going to map out the intensity and the polarization of the light that we can see from the sky. And that'll be a combination of primordial radiation, so light that has been traveling since the Big Bang, since the beginning of the universe, and also intensity from the galaxy. So we have to disentangle those two, and we'll map out what that part of the sky looks like, and we'll be able to, you know, model it and determine, you know, the parameters that kind of govern what the universe was like at the very beginning.
So the schedule for a balloon launch like this is essentially that you need to qualify for a long-duration balloon flight the summer prior to a launch, within a few weeks of Christmas. Normally the process, and what we did last year, was that you would deploy your instrument to the CSBF facility in Palestine, Texas, and you would integrate the payload there, and you would test it with all of the flight systems that are provided by NASA. And once you've demonstrated that they all play well together, then you ship directly from that facility in Texas to Antarctica. We went through that process last year, but then of course the government shutdown resulted in the cancellation of all of the flights. Because we did it last year, we're staying here this year. But it's the same schedule. That is, we'll integrate it all in the high bay here. The team will meet the payload and all the equipment in Antarctica about the second week of October. The first groups will leave from here. And then you really have the month of November and the first 3 weeks of December to set up a lab, build the experiment, calibrate it, make sure it's all working, and get it ready for launch.
SPIDER is awesome. It's studying like the Big Bang. It's almost unbelievable that we can test what SPIDER wants to test. And so I get to do that while building a really cool robot to make that happen. And then I fly it in the stratosphere from Antarctica. So I get to like do this really cool thing in this really awesome way, and it's great.
You know, as a scientist, these are the kinds of questions you really want answers to, right? The big questions about how did the universe, you know, why are we here to some extent, right? SPIDER is a really cool instrument to do that with. You know, ballooning in general is really cool. It's really fun as a young scientist to get involved with that kind of instrument. And these kinds of projects naturally lead to, you know, satellite instruments and larger scale science. So it's a really good jumping off point as a graduate student to get involved with this kind of project.